Hey guys, this is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we're back in Sudan and we're testing some tailings out through one of our hammer mills onto a gold catcha, and then we're going to clean up the concentrates from the gold catcha on one of our shaker tables. And our goal here is to take the tailings from some of the cone mills or wet pan mills that the locals are using now, run them through, concentrate them down, and see how much gold and mercury we can recover. The material is falling from the hammer mill down into the gold catcha, which is a spinning concentrating bowl. And here the tailings are coming out down into the sluice, which really is just acting more like a trough to get the tailings out into the tailings pond here. And here in a minute we'll get the hammer mill opened up, take a look, and then we'll clean out the concentrates from the gold catcha and run them on the shaker table to see how much mercury we recovered. Here's the inside of one of the small 12x9s, and the hammers are wearing a little bit here, yeah? And do you ever have problems with the pins wearing or the rotors wearing? It doesn't look like it. So a 0.5 millimeter screen? 0.4?
Yes.
So this is the gold catcha.
Yes. And this is the concentrate.
Concentrate, and this is from tailings from the cone mills.
Yeah.
So it looks like it packs up the riffles pretty good, huh?
Yeah. Much of the metals, the mercury here in this.
So what's this? What's this now?
This is the concentrate here,
mm-hmm.
And this is like a plug so that it doesn't drain all the way down.
Oh, I see.
But there is a lot of concentrate as well inside.
Yeah.
Now what we'll wash it.
Much of the ore, much of the materials should be inside here.
Mm.
Maybe 70% here.
Okay.
The rest.
And so it feeds in from the hammer mill.
Yes.
Into the gold catcha, and the bowl's spinning. And the material flows up the sides and out the top.
Yes.
And then you have the sluice to check the tailings.
Yeah.
How fast does the bowl spin?
About 90 RPM.
90 RPM.
Yeah.
So it doesn't go very fast at all. And it's maybe 2 feet in diameter at the top. 20 inches to 24 inches at the top. And it's a single phase motor.
It comes three phase or single phase. This one is, I believe, is a single phase.
Uh-huh.
It runs out of a motor with a gearbox.
Uh-huh.
The speed is 200 RPM.
Oh, so you just pulled the plug and.
This is the
screen.
Yeah.
But then it's also, I didn't realize this until.
It's a cone.
It's a funnel.
Yeah.
Oh, can we pull it? Can we open it? Yeah. Okay, so that feeds down into the middle, right into the bowl. And that's where the best concentrates are in the bowl. And then anything that flows out has to go up these riffles to get out. That's cool. Now he's taking the concentrates from the gold catcha here and running them on the shaker table to upgrade them.
Okay.
turn the water down a little bit. Yeah, here.
One really big blob.
Yeah.
The thing is that they like leech.
Back here too? Yeah, all the way along here.
2 minutes of the shape.
Yeah.
So we have everything.
You see, when we flush it like this, you can see what's beneath here.
Uh-huh.
Black sand. Yellow iron dust, dilgudra.
Yeah.
And this light gray. This is very fine gold, super fine gold.
Yeah, with mercury.
This is collect with mercury.
Yeah.
But don't collect.
Tons of mercury.
I don't know if you need to be careful pouring the water that's coming.
Oh yeah, don't pour it too, yeah, not too much. So is this typical of the amount of mercury you see in the bags?
Yes.
So this is every two bags will have about this much mercury?
Yes.
Wow.
Sometimes more.
Sometimes more.
Yes, but this is like
no, depending on what you get on the origin of the gold. When the more mercury you find, it means the source was rich in gold.
Okay.
If you don't find mercury in the tailings, it means the original source was poor in gold.
Okay.
You should get. You're not convinced, Dylan.
We've taken the concentrates that we brushed down off the table, and now they're panning out the last bits of sand and material, and we'll get the clean mercury that they can then squeeze the gold out of, and we can weigh the mercury to find out how much mercury we recovered, as well as the gold bead once we get the gold cleaned from the mercury. Now they're adding dilute nitric acid to coalesce the mercury into a single bead, as well as clean some of the impurities from the remaining concentrates. So they don't burn the mercury here, they use nitric?
No.
They burn it. Well, won't the nitric dissolve the mercury? So tell me again about the nitric. You put the nitric in with the mercury and the concentrates, and it collects all the mercury together.
Yeah.
Even the flowered mercury, everything brings it all.
It's
the same thing. I think a car battery.
The thing is, but it's just melting.
But it's not used. It takes the iron out and some things like that. But it takes
most of it, not all of it.
Uh-huh.
So you can find residual after this process, residual of the iron oxides, which make the mercury less dense.
Yeah. Okay.
You can see it just
iron
from
nitrate,
here,
which is a salt.
Yeah, iron nitrate. Yeah.
And it's a salt.
You see it?
Yeah, he's going to clean it up real nice. And now we can take that and weigh it. Can we get this weighed?
At
the gold buyer or something?
We can get this.
So there's most of the mercury, yeah? So can you pour it into your thing? Or get a picture in? Okay, so what do we have here? We ran 150 to 200 kilograms of tailings. We've got our mercury recovered here. And we're going to try and weigh it and figure out how much mercury we have recovered from 200 grams. We're not really quite sure how this process is going to work, but our goal is to get a weight on the mercury and a weight on the gold.
Squeeze. Yeah. Look more at that. Come on, easy. How's it going? That time, he will wet it and then squeeze it. You take the total weight.
Total weight?
Yes, and then squeeze it.
Okay. So the dish weighs 32.5 grams. So there's 18 grams of stuff in there.
Yeah.
A little bit of black sand, mostly mercury by weight. Okay, now we can squeeze it out and weigh the mercury again. We're going with the information we can get, you know.
The pipette to get rid of some of that sediment. Squeeze it out around that. go with the flow.
Yeah.
Arsonists use it, and when they attempt to use it, they use deuterium, soap, and
clean it.
Sodium chloride.
Mm-hmm.
I think so, yeah, a little bit.
So that's all mercury that's been saved from the...
And look at on his fingers! Yeah, that's all mercury that was removed from the environment at this point, because it's just tailings. So now, can we get another weight on this mercury?
Yes.
Can we weigh that mercury? Yeah, okay. So there's the mercury recovered. All right, we've got all the mercury we can out of the rag. Your amalgam here. So there's a little bit of gold. Here's our mercury. We're gonna go weigh our clean mercury and see how much mercury we recovered from 150 to 200 kilograms. Yeah. Yeah. 45.5.
So we're good. 45? 45.
So there's 13 grams of mercury there.
Yes.
13 grams.
32.5,
yes,
yes. 45.5,
so yeah, 13 grams of mercury. And here's the final results. We ended up with 13 grams of mercury from about 150 kilograms of tailings. So if you stretch that out, and in 1 ton of tailings, there's about 85 to 90 grams of mercury that we can recover on our shaker table. And then here is the gold amalgam that we recovered. And again, from that 150 kilograms, we recovered 0.6 grams of gold. And so in 1 ton of tailings, there's around 4 grams of gold to be recovered that was lost by the cone mills.